Okay, so at this point you have edited your videos that you created in Yuja, and now you want to link to them in your course. Now, it's tempting to just let students come into Yuja and just see all the videos that you might have created or uploaded. And the problem with that is that they have to then sift through all of your videos to figure out which video they need for this particular week, this particular assignment or unit. So that's not very efficient for them, and it becomes really frustrating for them. Plus, we are trying to make sure that everybody uses the content area for the actual course content, and not in announcements, or not have students coming here and just watch everything here in a disorganized manner. So to that end, I'm going to show you how to actually add your videos into your content area in two different ways. So I'm going to go over to My Media so that I can get to these features for each video I've created. So go through some of these features because they're actually pretty cool. You can come to More, and there's all these different, you know, you can link a quiz to it. You can see the analytics of this video and who's watching it. You can do all kinds of good stuff with that. We actually need this links area. Now, you're going to be tempted to try to use the share feature, but this share feature isn't actually sharing. It's like you sharing this one video with one person in your class, which is not what we're using this for. If, however, you make one video for one student, you could use this share feature for that. But to share the video in the content area, you need to go to this More option and choose Links so that you can get this direct link. We can also embed this video in lecture notes if you'd like, so that students can actually watch the video with the lecture notes on the screen. And I'll show you how to do that in a second. So I'm going to go ahead and copy with Control C or Command C and click Save Links and close it. And then I'm going to go to the content area and choose the unit I want it in. So let's pretend it's in the research paper unit. And then I'm going to go to Upload Create and choose Create a Link. I'll give this a link. So I always like to do video test video 1. So obviously you would have a different title, but I like putting this in here so that students know what content they should expect when they click on this link. So I will paste that URL in there. You could open this as an external resource, and normally we would do that for like an outside website, but because this is actually a video you created in this course, I wouldn't recommend that, because then it's going to open it up as a new tab. So I'll go ahead and click Create, and as this reloads, you can see that it's going to load it into a page just for that video. And if we go back to this Unit 1 module, you can see that there's now this link here. So what happens if we want to actually embed it in lecture notes? Well, let's first create some lecture notes. I'll create a new file, and I'm going to call this lecture notes, and give this a title, and here, pretend this is some content because I'm too lazy to actually write stuff, and I'll make that a heading 1 so it's noticeable, and this is where we want to embed our video. So I'm going to go ahead and save and close these lecture notes, go back into Yuja, and click on the My Media area, and we're going to go back into More and Links, and this time we're going to copy this, embed this video. So I'm going to do Control C or Command C and click Close, go back to Content, and go back into our lecture notes, and I want to edit the HTML for this, or just basically edit the page, and click where I want the video. So I might even have more lecture notes down here, and I want this video to go here because I've just talked about whatever I'm going to show in this video. So I'm going to click this first button called Insert Stuff and find Enter Embed Code, and then I'm going to paste that in there. You don't have to change anything about this, but let's go ahead and click Next. I've already changed the setting on this, but before, when I first tried to embed this video, it said this content was blocked and it had like an allow question button to see if you wanted to allow this. So I did click allow. So now you can see this preview, and then I hit insert, and my video is now in my lecture notes. Just so you know, in order for you to see this, if it didn't give you that allow option, if you're in Google Chrome, which I highly recommend, make sure you have the latest version as well. You can always go up to this little lock information, and it'll say, do you want to allow pop-ups and redirects? And you can choose, and that's because pop-ups and redirects might have been the last thing that it was trying to do on this site. But if you go to site settings, you can come in here and you can choose what it should ask. Like if you want it to ask before it uses your webcam or ask before it uses your microphone, or see how it's blocking flash here. For me, a lot of my content does have some flash in it. So I actually choose to come in here and do allow, and it's only going to allow it for this D2L URL. So this mcc.desiretolearn.com. So it won't allow it for every other website, but for here, it's fine. So you can also do that or direct your students to do that if for some reason they're not able to see your content. So it automatically saves. I can go ahead and click, and you can come change this whenever you want. You can also reset your permissions. So I'll close that and save and close. And there's the embedded video in your lecture notes. So again, we highly recommend that you keep all of your content for the course organized in the content area. Do it by units, do it by weeks. Do it however you think would be easiest for students, but we're really trying to get them used to the fact that if they go to the content page, all of their assignments and content are on that one page.